let's take a look at another attack involving untrusted data. And this time, I want to look at cookie poisoning. Now, a cookie is untrusted data because it's part of the request header. So when you make a request for a website, any cookies which are valid for that domain are automatically sent. Now you can hit F12 to jump into the developer tools, jump over to resources, down into cookies, and then look at the domain that we're interested in. And here are all the cookies that are automatically getting sent with every request that we make to hackyourselffirst.troyhunt.com. These cookies are persisted in the browser. The browser is automatically sending them, and we can modify them at multiple points. So we could create our own HTTP request using something like wget or using a tool like Fiddler, or we could just simply modify the cookie values in the browser itself. And this is what I want to do here because there's one cookie in particular that I find quite interesting. And it's this one. It's this isAdmin flag again. And it's set to false. But as we've seen in the previous couple of clips, things get a bit interesting when we make this isAdmin flag true. So let's do that. I'm going to jump over to the console, and now we can write JavaScript that will execute in the DOM of the browser for this website, so in the document object model. Now let's do this. I'm going to write document.cookie equals, and then the name of the cookie, which is isAdmin, and then I'm going to set it to true. Now I can just hit enter and it's going to execute that. So that should now have set our cookie to true. So let's go and take a look at that. We're going to go back to resources, and then in our cookies, we can see that isAdmin is now true. Let's now close the DevTools, and I'm going to click a link, which is now going to cause that cookie to be sent in the next request. So let's go over to the leaderboard. And here is my admin link in the navigation bar again. So we're back to where we were in the last couple of clips. We've exposed functionality by modifying untrusted data. The only difference is, rather than modifying a hidden field or mounting a mass assignment attack, we've simply changed this little piece of data which is persisted in the client. And that has resulted in exactly the same risk as the other parameter tampering examples. So that is cookie poisoning, changing the value of the cookie in order to give the attacker an advantage.